Chapter 10, Disagreeableness. Begin all acts and thinking by using El Kalum the All. Tablet 6, for him that waits on Tammuz the Messiah, 19 times 1 equals 19. Lo, eating and drinking the servants of Anu at the table prepared for the beloved of Anu, Elion, Elion El. Truly HaMashiach alone knows what he has prepared for him that awaits on him. The fools in their folly claim this divine being, this Ilam Utachazid, this avatar. Each of them wish to have faith that he belongs to them. How long shall this be? Some say a millennium, others say 7,000 years, and others say 440 years. The El Masa will come, the Buddha will come, the Krishna will come, the Christ will come, Maitreya will come, and Tammuz will come. Blessed is he who waits and endures until the end, and loses not one speck of faith. He shall receive the gold crown, preserved for those who follow the Lamb wherever he goes. They will become a king over earthly kings, and a master over the earthly masters. His knowledge shall increase, his wisdom shall endure, and he has an overstanding. Tablet 7. Who will dwell where? 19 times 2 equals 38. Lo, 99 out of 1,000 shall go into the fire, in the time which Cadmon son of Autumn and Lilith was in the enclosed garden. I expected 90% of your faith, now it will only take 10% to re-enter paradise. The beautiful maidens who meet the agreeable at the departure of the planet Earth. For 3 generations, even the sinners in hell are released from pain, when they acknowledge the agreeable of the divine judgment. While joining in the praise of Anu, Elion, Elion, El, by the agreeable Anunnaki. They that have trespassed the will of Anu will dwell in the valley of weeping, which is Jahannam, or purgatory. They maketh a well of tears to quench its fire and their praise. Praise him who decideth the judgment. On the way to the garden. The agreeable maidens who meet the agreeable at the departure from the heart, the black-eyed maidens, are promised to the faithful from the holy place as a personification of his virtues to fill him with delight. We have the disagreeable maidens who meet the sinners as a personification of his guilt to horrify him, parallel by the law saying that the agreeable will be heralded by groups of agreeable Anunnaki. Black-eyed maidens called out, he earneth his peace, he walketh forward to his goal, and the sinners will be met by 3 groups of chastising disagreeable Anunnaki, who will call, there is no peace for the wicked, no peace for the soul suffering from spiritual diseases, cries of torment in a pit with whipping and gnashing of teeth, the pain of being roasted, boiled in oil, chained to the wall of a hot open furnace, the devil with a pitchfork, which is hot and pointed, standing by grinning and poking you, half-human weird-looking monsters with grotesque bodies of strange mangled parts, and the heads of flesh-eating animals and birds. Yield that the agreeable may pass on their way to the new world, the crystal city, the new enclosed garden. They being entangled by the paths on their ways, and they go into desolation and perish. They perish because they cannot attain everlasting life herein. And that is the great symbolisms for those who need to see their future through fear. Tablet 8. Man's archenemy. 19 times 2 equals 38. Lo, tell them this. I have been inspired by that group of malevolent beings, cherubims, the jinn, who are also beings from Aldebaran, Pleiades and Arcturus constellations, that listened, and they, the malevolent beings, cherubims, the jinn, have heard an amazing reading, El Quran, the Quran, guiding to the right way, so that the malevolent beings, cherubims, the jinns, can have faith in it, the Quran, and we, the malevolent beings, cherubims and jinns, will not bind partners with you, O our Rab, you are alone. Surely he is the Most High, the Majestic, and our Master, and he has not taken unto himself a companion wife, and not a son by birth. Surely a nation of fools, Jews from amongst us, used to utter blasphemies about the source Anu. Surely we, the Allahumma Anunnaki, thought that the Enoshites and the malevolent beings, cherubims, the jinns, did not utter blasphemies and lies about the source. Surely they were mortal men from amongst Enoshites, who sought refuge with mortal men, who are from amongst the malevolent beings Garubat, the Jinns. So they increased in their oppression. And surely they thought, as all of you thought, that the source would not raise anyone. And surely we sought to touch the skies, so we discovered it to be filled with strong guards, the malevolent beings Cherubims, the Jinns, and beings of light attacking. And surely we, the malevolent Enoshites, Jinn Enoshites, used to squat in the squatting places in order to listen. So as for him who attempts to listen, now he finds a flaming beam coming at him. And surely we, the malevolent beings Cherubims, the Jinns, don't perceive if wickedness is intended by those beings in the planet Earth, Adamites, or whether their master intends to guide them rightly. It was surely from us, the benevolent beings, the Seraphim, are those ones who are perfect in their beings, and those who are other than that, the malevolent beings, Cherubims, the Jinn. We Seraphims and Cherubims have many ways. Surely if we, the Alhum and Unakai, thought it was over, the war between the Alhum and Unakai in the skies, and we, the malevolent beings, Garubat Cherubims, 200 fallen malevolent and Unakai Alhum, won't escape the source in the planet Earth, nor will we, the malevolent beings, Garubat, escape him by fleeing from him. Surely when we, the malevolent beings Garubat, heard the guidance, the Quran, we had faith in it. Thus, whoever has total faith in his sustainer, he has no fear of loss nor of oppression. Surely there are some from amongst us, the Alhum and Unakai, who are peacemakers, the benevolent beings Sarufat, and also from amongst us there are the unjust, the malevolent beings the Garubat. But as for those of you who surrender in peace, these are those of you Enoshites who seek the right direction. And the evil one was put out of the Orion skies. That's that old snake called Zuin, the evil one, reptilian Shakar or Tarnush and Satan, who deceived the whole world. He was put out and into the planet Earth, him and his disagreeable Anunnaki Garubat with him. And there was a being in the Orion skies, Mikael, and his agreeable arch messenger Anunnaki Alahum Sarufat, who fought against Zuin, the evil one, and his disagreeable arch messenger Anunnaki. As for the unjust one, they will be fuel of purgatory. If they, the Meccans, stay upright, on the way we, the Alhum and Unakai, will give them drinking water abundantly, for they will be tested in it, and whoever disregards it and is neglectful about remembering his Rab, he will make them undergo a severe pain. And surely the places of prostration are for the source alone, so don't call out to anyone in conjunction with Anu. And surely when the slave of Allah, Abraham, rose up, he, Abraham, called out unto him the source. And then they, Nimrod's Enoshites, surrounded him, almost stifling him, Abraham. Tell them this. Surely only I call out to my sustainer, and I do not associate anything with him. He, the source Anu, is alone. Tell them this. Surely I myself don't possess in my power the rulership over you, and can't harm or guide you aright. Ahmed has no power except from the source. Tell them this, Ahmed. Surely I, Muhammad, will not find protection from anyone besides the source Anu, and I will not find a place of refuge except in him. It is nothing except a proclamation, preaching from the facts from the source, Anu and his messengers. And whoever disobeys Anu and the one sent by him, surely for them is the fire of purgatory. In it they will reside eternally, until they see what it all adds up to. So they shall learn, who is a weak aider and has less in numbers. Tell them this, Muhammad, if I could but perceive whether it is near to what it all adds up to be, or if he, my Rab, is making for it a lengthy term. Knower of the unseen things, thus he, the source Anu, does not manifest the hidden things that are his to anyone, except for him whom he chooses, from the one sent by him, his Rasul. So surely he makes a pass from between his hands, and from behind him a guard, for him to know that indeed they, the news bearers, delivered the messages of their Rab, who is the sustainer master, and he, the source, is fully aware of all that is in their presence, and his news bearers, the source Anu, takes account of everything. Tablet 9, the time. 19 times 2 equals 38. Lo, didn't the period of time exist of which he, the Enoshite, was not a thing even to be remembered? Surely we, the Alhum and Unakai, procreated the Enoshite from semen mixed with ovum, that we may test him. So we, the Alhum, made him hearing and seeing. Surely we, the Alhum, guided him to the path, agreeable way to do things. It is up to him to either be grateful or ungrateful, concealing that which he knows to be the facts. Surely we Allahumma Nunakai and Malik, the Allahumma over hell, have prepared chains and shackles for the concealers of the facts. Surely the righteous ones will drink from a cup which has a mixture of balm and camphor. He, the righteous Muslim, will drink from a spring which is for the slaves of the source anew, which their faith make flow on and on. They, the righteous Muslims, who fulfill their promise and have fear of a day in which all of his wickedness will be seen far and wide. And they, the righteous Muslims, feed and give food out of love to the poor settlers and orphans and the captives. Surely we only feed you all the needy for the sake of the source anew, and we don't want anything from you, no reward, not even a thank you. Surely we, the faithful, only have fear from our sustainer El Elo when the horror of a day of calamity will come. Surely the source anew will protect them, the righteous Muslims, peaceful ones, from the wickedness that will overshadow them in that day and cause them to shine in a radiance and happiness. And he shall reward them, the righteous Muslims, because they were patient in waiting for the enclosed garden of delight and the silk garb as worn in it. They will be relaxing on exalted couches. They, the righteous Muslims, will not see in it the enclosed garden, the sun beaming downward, nor intense coldness, and in it the enclosed garden, the shade will hang low over them. For the righteous Muslims, bunches of grapes will be made to hang low in reach, and vessels of silver shall be circulated in cups which are of fine translucent crystal. Translucent glasses with silver trim, they, the righteous Muslims, will have all that they desire. And they, the righteous Muslims, shall be given a drink in it, the enclosed garden, out of cups which have a mixture of spices of ginger, from a spring which is in it, the enclosed garden, having the name of that which shall flow. And all around them, the righteous Muslims, they will see youths with immortality. And when you, the righteous Muslims, see them, you will conclude that they, the immortal youths, are black pearls scattered about. And when you, the righteous Muslims, look around in the enclosed garden, then you will see the grace of the source anew and his great splendid rulership. They, the little kids, the righteous, will have on velvet green and silk robes, garments, brocades, and shall also have on silver bracelets, and their sustainer master, who is Rab, shall give them, the righteous, a pure drink. Surely this reward is for you all, whose efforts are striving, you all are worthy of thanks. Surely we Anunnaki ourselves sent down the Quran to you, Ahmed, also known as Muhammad. It was us, the Allahum, who sent it down. So stay patient for the judgment of your Muhammad Rab Anu, and don't obey any of them who are doers of disagreeable acts, or those who conceal that which they know to be the facts. And you are to remember the name of your master sustainer, who is Rab Anu, in the early daytime hour, and on through the shadow hour period. And at the shadow hour period, you are to prostrate to him, Anu, like Muhammad did, and glorify him, for the shadow hour period is long. Surely these are the lovers of letting time pass, wasting time, just to try and put a grievous day behind them. And we, the Allahumma Nunakai, created them, the worldly Enoshites, and made them firm, look as if they have it all. If we please, we Allahum can exchange them, the worldly Enoshites, with others just like them. It is a simple exchange. Surely this is a remembrance to you all. So it, this degree of reading, is for all of those who are to be put on the path of his Rab, and whatever you will is nothing, except that which the source Anu wills for you. Surely the source Anu is wise, knowing. And he, the source Anu, will allow them to enter his enclosed garden whom he pleases, out of his yielding mercy, and he has prepared an aching pain for the unjust ones. Tablet 10, Nuwapu, 19 times 2 equals 38. Lo! What are they, the human beings, asking each other about? It is about the supreme news, Nuwapu, that which they, human beings, are differed. Nevertheless, they Enoshites will soon learn about the science of Nuwapu, then nevertheless, they will really learn. And we, the masters, ask, what does Nuwapu mean to you? Should we embark upon these Enoshites the science of Nuwapu? Nuwapu is the science of sound right reasoning, and its followers are the sons and daughters of sound right reasoning. Belief is ignorance. Belief is to ignore the facts intentionally or unintentionally. Also, Nuwapu is right knowledge, right wisdom, and right understanding. If one has to believe, it means he or she does not know. And if one does not know, That is ignorance. Hence, belief is ignorance, and religious beliefs without the facts is ignorance. So demand that anyone attempting to impose on you their religious beliefs, they are to produce the facts. The most deceptive word in religion is the word belief or believe, because a person can believe in anything, and this means that a person can believe and be 100% wrong. But knowledge is knowing, and knowledge is correct information. To know gives one confidence, but belief infers doubt. Knowledge can be checked out by one or more of three tests: experience, evidence, and reason. Knowledge is always logical, and it reasons out. The first step to Nawaku is the right knowledge, which will pass any one of the three tests that is practical for the knowledge given. One cannot always use the experience test, because the experience test is not practical for all knowledge. The evidence and reason tests are those tests that are more often practical, yet Nawaku is the science of experience, evidence, and reason, because 9 Ether is the power of reason. 9 Ether forces first visit the minds of their posterity, descendants, because they know that nothing can be done right unless the mind is right. The mind cannot be right unless it has accepted right knowledge. 6 Ether in ghost causes Negroes to commit suicide, because that is just what people are doing when they run up against the adverse forces with sticks and stones, while their enemy has tanks with blazing machine guns. 6 Ether and ghost activate people's mind foolishly to provoke their enemy and their helpers to shoot them down. So 6 Ether and ghost will have innocent blood to subsist off, so that these two spirit forces, 6 Ether and ghost, will get stronger in the atmosphere and maintain enemy's economic strength and religion, and this will prolong their dominance. The solution to the racial, economic, moral, spiritual, and social problems of a people is the elimination by facts of the negative. Tablet 11, 9 Ether. 19 times 7 equals 133. Lo, the slave mentally and the Urapu influenced religions, be it Christianity, Judaism, or Islam, or whatever denomination or sect, should all be eliminated, and this elimination will lead to right thinking. Right thinking will lead to right action for liberty and equality with the help of the forces of nature. There's nothing wrong with violence for liberty and equality if you have a chance to win, but there is no chance without 9 Ether spirit forces to counteract the adverse forces and to show you the way to liberty and equality. You cannot see the way until the mind's eye is open. There is no solution to the problem and miserable conditions of people anywhere unless you have a solution that is workable everywhere. Offer all people a do-it-yourself solution until you get strong and united enough mentally to do what you must do together physically. All of you who can work diligently and with determination towards eliminating negative and slave mentalities, you all can do this privately without committing suicide by provoking the visible adverse forces to brutalities and atrocities against you, by joining the ancient mystical order of Melchizedek and reading and studying each tablet. You will thoroughly go a long way towards eliminating the negative and opposing forces. This process leads to liberty and success for humanity in general by opposing or adverse invisible forces, I mean the opposite of those visible adverse forces. There are forces of racism against all races that you do not see, that wear a smile and shake your hand. But behind closed doors, these principalities in high places are responsible for trickling down racism and race wars. This is what I refer to as invisible adverse forces. If you have free minds, you will do free things. If you have equal minds to other races, you will do equal things. Think equal or greater than other races, because mental capacity as incarnations of original creative forces are greater than that of others once your mind breaks free from prison. Freedom requires a free mind and responsibilities of a free mind. Equality requires an equal mind and the responsibilities of an equal mind. Universal knowledge, called Nawaku, informs you, new beings, that there are three creations: original or primary creation, evolutionary or secondary creation, and ghostational or tertiary creation. Primary creation was performed by 9 Ether, whose science is Nawaku. 9 Ether is the combination of all existing gases of nature, thus all is in the all. Nothing anywhere can be as powerful as all existing gases. Therefore, 9 Ether is the most potent power in the universes, 9 to the 9th power of 9. 9 is a very meaningful number. It is symbolic of heaven, hell, and creation. 9 is a number whose square root is 3, a number which is symbolic of the 3 dimensions. Thus, Sut, Abode of the Mortals, Malakut, Abode of the Ununukai Elohim, and Lahut, Abode of the Most High. And 9 is the number when multiplied, reproduces the same figures from up to down and from down to up, and equals itself. 9 ether was placed in the follicle case of all original Nubians, and it produces a 9 symbol. When the number 9 is inverted or perverted, it becomes the number 6, the number of the disagreeable Elohim and their nature. Hence, 9 ether is the original creator who grew all the universes. In the Nuwupu, the word creation means growth into form, or system, or both, and the word destruction means change in the form or composition, or both. 9 ether is conscious, awareness and conscience, moral judgment, guesses. The new being race comes along with the original creation, that is, the same kind of ether forces that grew the universes. Their evolutionary descendants are the personification of the original creative forces. The first physical beings created in the universe is in their spirit form, 9 ether. Then they personified themselves as flesh and blood beings, Adamites. There are 2 kinds of ether, 9 ether, agreeable benevolent Elohim, and 6 ether, disagreeable malevolent Elohim. 9 ether produces 6 ether, and 6 ether produces ghost. 9 ether becomes 6 ether through time and age, and 6 ether becomes ghost through time and age. 6 ether is 9 ether in death, and ghost is the death of 6 ether. After the death of 6 ether, called the moon or ghost cycle, 9 ether rises again. Hence 6 ether is adverse to 9 ether, just as death is averse to life. 9 ether is ether in its youth, strength and old age, and 6 ether is ether in death. Therefore, ghost is the death of death. Like everything else, when death gets old, it dies, and ether comes back to life in the person of 9 ether, the Ethiopian ether utopian forces of nature. The sun, El Roy, called Ra, and the other true stars generate ether, but 9 ether first generated the physical bodies of the suns. In other words, the suns, the true stars of the universes, are self-created, meaning self-grown, by the power that they now reproduce from the all. They are the Sarufat, agreeable Elohim. The science in the Nuwupu tells you just how and when, but it suffices to state at this time that evolution or secondary creation started 17,250,000 years ago, and it was performed by 6 ether beings, whose science is Rahoa, which tells them how to destroy and disrupt, and just when it will suffice. They are the manifestation of those Garubat, disagreeable Elohim. And 6 ether today is known as Leviathan, Zeus, Lord, Baal, Satan, Tagut, Kanaz, Nakash, Samael, Jupiter, Vishnu, Sol, Molech, Iblis, Od, Shaitan, Jinn, Shakar, Devil, Legbar, Beelzebub, Lucifer, Azazel, etc. 6 ether is also known as Sin, Shiva, Anubis, Tahuti, Set, God, etc. And in its moon or ghost manifestation, spiritual, that which is spiritus, simply meaning breathe or breathing. Evolution was partial destruction of the original creation, because destruction is change in the form or composition or both. In order to create, you have to destroy something else for this new thing that you're trying to create to exist. 6 ether, the evolutionary forces, is ether with less gases than 9 ether. Therefore, it has a different nature than 9 ether, and this is why the hair of the Ununukai original man was woolly. Hamsan Kena'anan, or as they would have you say it, Hamsan Kanan, was the first human albino, and he had woolly hair, but his genes were defected. It resulted in a thinner texture of hair, which means his hair has less strength than the woolly hair of the new beings, Nubans, because woolly hair was produced by a more potent gas formula, 9 ether. There are many Nubians and people of color that have straight hair. It is just a scientific fact that the curlier the hair, the stronger the gene, meaning more gases in the formula. 6 ether is conscious gases, ghost is conscious gases, which has less various gases in it than 6 ether. Therefore, ghost is a weaker gas combination than 6 ether, just as 6 ether is weaker than 9 ether. 9 ether is effective fluid fire. Ghostation, or tertiary creation, was done by God, Ghost, 6,000 years ago. This is one reason why their descendants taught the captive, these new beings, that the so-called God created the world and man 6,000 years ago. However, they did not tell the captive that they meant the Karkasu world and the Karkasu man or race. The spirituality of their God is religion. The Tamahus of the planet Earth were the beginning of their God's creation 4,000 years before 2,000 years ago, when 6 FIFA reaches its climax in evolution, it produces Ghost, and Ghost is God. The offspring of Nynaepha is the new being, the woolly-haired Tar, or Pygmies, also called the evolutionary man. The offspring of Sixaepha is the Garu Bat, the straight-haired original man. The offspring of Ghost is the Carcassu race, the straight-haired mooncycle man. Who was extracted from the original man through a ghosting process, the curse of leprosy? When it's seen with a spiritual eye, Ghost looks like a haze or a fog. This means that Ghost is pale, and thereby the last stage of colour. Hence, since the Carcassu race came into being by ghostation, it has less colour than any other race. All the original Canaanites had silver or yellow hair, white skin, and blue eyes, except one tribe, the Hamathites. But the new race now has various degrees of mixture with darker peoples. The etymological, original meanings of the English language words are an education in itself, because it opens up the eyes and shows how the Canaanites have changed the value, meaning, and purpose of things in order to set up supremacy for their kind. The word God is an example. In order to make his creator stronger through belief and deception, he had to state that it is called the One Supreme Being, and we call it the Almighty. However, the definition he gives for the word God is not the complete definition of the One Supreme Being or Almighty. The One Supreme is infinite, of omnipotent nature, who has innumerable parts and powers called Anu, the Source, the Supreme Being, appointed by El Kalun the All. To be a part of what is called the Elohim, the Spirit Beings, Supreme Beings, God therefore can only be a motivating and activating part of the Evil One as their Supreme Being, the Evil Supreme Being, the Almighty that gives them their power over you. If you pray to their deities by name, you help give them power to keep you down. The All is all, and everything existing, living and dead, visible and invisible, male and female, good and evil angelic beings, flesh and spirit, etc., are all in the All. The only name, attribute, that is sufficient as the right name for the One Supreme is the one that means all and everything existing in all space, all matter, all time, and their products in the word God does not fit this definition. The etymological, original meaning of the word God is ghost, and ghost is of death. Ghost is God, and spirit of the cemetery or necropolis. Ghost is God of the dead, mentally and physically dead. Ghost is God, and God is ghost. The word ghost means gas, from Middle English ghost, from Old English ghast, meaning breath, spirit. It is the gas of death for Nubians, and life for Tamahus, because Tamahus are its offspring. The manifestation of Ghost started with Cain killing Abel, and it has been magnifying and manifesting itself through killing and death ever since. Now all people on the earth kill, as evidenced by the Bible and its history. When reading the stories of the Bible, the people of it are about murder, war, rape, incest, lies, deception, prostitution, betrayal, and favoritism. Stories of love, peace, and happiness are rare. This is your so-called holy book.